Published 0611, est, the 9th of November 2017, updated 0650, est, the 9th of November 2017. A mother of three who was raped by her long-term partner while she slept has described the horrific ordeal and said she was physically abused every day. Rebecca Bellini, 33, has waived her anonymity to speak out after her abusive ex-boyfriend Neil Parrish, also 33, was jailed for 11 years after raping her multiple times. Miss Bellini, from Chelmsford, S, started her seven-year relationship with Parrish in May 2010 and said that she instantly fell in love with him. He was diagnosed with cancer, but she said things rapidly changed when he received the all clear and started going out on the lash and taking cocaine. Rebecca Bellini, 33, has waived her anonymity to speak out after her abusive ex-boyfriend Neil Parrish, also 33, was jailed for 11 years, speaking from her mother's home in Great Barrow, S, where she is currently living before she is rehoused. She said that rape became the norm. She said rape and abuse became the norm. We met through mutual friends at the end of 2009. It wasn't until May 2010 that we got together. He had cancer when he moved and I became the carer for everyone. Miss Bellini, who has a six-year-old daughter with Parrish, added he stayed over one night and moved in after that. I was so in love, I didn't care. It was about a year after the all clear that he started going out on the lash, taking coke, speed and weed. I did not know whether he was always like that and whether the cancer had been a mask for what he was really like. I would be verbally and physically abused every day. Parrish's hold over Miss Bellini meant she would isolate herself from her friends and family, even to the extent where she would return home from work early if he asked her to, but perhaps most sickening of all was her account of how he would force her to perform acts on him. He would demand that she would come to the bedroom via text and email and would even use it as a form of punishment. She said he would do it to me if I hadn't done the washing up, if I had spoken to him funny or if I rolled my eyes at him. I would sob and I would tell him I didn't want to. I cried during it after he would say good girl. If I came in the room and didn't do something right, he would tell me to go out and come in again. Miss Bellini started a relationship with Parrish, pictured together in May 2010, and said that she instantly fell in love with him. Her difficult living situation was compounded by the fact that her three children saw the abuse she was receiving firsthand. She said, I felt trapped even though I knew my family would support me. I didn't want to bring other people into it. Our daughter told the police about him spitting and hitting me. She saw it all the time. Miss Bellini had finally had enough and left Parrish on April 27. He was arrested in the early hours of the following day. She said people asked me what had happened on the day to make me finally leave him, but nothing major had happened. I had just had enough. I was hysterical in my police interview. I did not go into the police station for him to be arrested. I just wanted him to be aware that the police knew about it. I kept saying that he would kill me if I got him arrested, and I didn't actually think what he had done was that bad. Watching it back now, I feel like him in a documentary. I am a lot different now. Neil Parrish, pictured, was jailed for 11 years at Chelmsford Crown Court. The officers interviewing me told me this was one of the worst cases they had seen. I didn't believe them. Last Friday, she added, Parrish was sent down for his crimes at Chelmsford Crown Court. She said the minute he was remanded and refused bail, I got my life back. I had no emotion when I heard him sentenced in court. It did not bother me. But in terms of the future, I will never put it behind me. He has affected me and my children so much. All that our daughter knows is that help's gone away for being naughty and for spitting at me and hitting me. I am going to keep the newspaper clippings and tell her the whole truth when she is older. As for my middle son, he is not sleeping well and is missing school. We all have flashbacks. We remember things that were happening a year ago today. Say if he had hit me. Miss Bellini hopes that by sharing her story, she can raise awareness of the issue with domestic abuse and rape. She said, I hope this shows people that rape does go on in a relationship. The fact that he was found guilty of rape, especially when I was sleeping as it was just my word against his, shows that they can go down for it. Parish of Chelmsford, S, was found guilty of 3 counts of rape, 1 count of affray and 1 count of assault by beating by a jury. He was acquitted of 4 separate counts of rape, 1 count of UAL assault by penetration, 1 count of assault by beating and 1 count of engaging in controlling a coercive behavior. He admitted 1 count of threatening to damage or destroy property. 1 count of rape and 1 count of assault by penetration will remain on his file. He was also slapped with a restraining order and will be on the sexual offenders register for the rest of his life.